Hello everyone, hope you are always safe and healthy wherever you are. Today, I will be talking about introduction to blogs app Automa. I will explain more about building a workflow at Automa with triggers and blocks, with awesome scenarios and using new features in Automa. Yesterday, we used record workflow, and maybe some of you do not know how the basic workflows are created on Automa. So, we will start with Automa editor. Go to the dashboard, select workflows from the left menu, adding a new workflow and typing for the name like example. We will have a trigger block as a starting point here, and we have many triggers to activate this workflow from this block. I will start with manually. We also have general, browser, web interaction, online service, and condition for any purpose here. Let's start with the browser. Let's say we need a new tab block here, and we will go to the Google Translate. We can connect it with the starting point here, and if we click on the Save and Run button, it will open Google Translate. Okay, we need to fill this input. We need to know what is this element, and we can use element selector from the Automa extension. So select the Automa extension and click on the element selector here. Click on this and click on the input form here. After we get the element selector here, we can copy and paste it to the editor. Back again to this workflow editor, and we can select form block here and pass the selector here. From the options, we can check wait for selector. Select text field and fill in the input. I will type hello semuanya. And we can adding a delay here for the humanized typing. Maybe 150. Connect it with the previous block and click on the save button here. And if we execute this workflow, it will open Google Translate and automatically type hello semuanya, and it translated to hi everybody. Next, what if we can translate a part of a web page and automatically open Google Translate and give us an English translation? Say no more. This is a new awesome feature from Automa. In the trigger block, we can change it to context menu, and we can give it a name like translate to English, and it will appear in selection. And from the forms block here, we need to update the input value here to a variable. Type double curly brackets and variables, add $CTX text selection, close the brackets. Of course, we need to click on the save button here. Let's say I have a Wikipedia page here and I want to translate this text. Select the text and right click, select the Automa and translate to English. It will open Google Translate and automatically type this on the input. And we will have an English translation here. Back again to the editor. And let's say we only need the translation running in the background and want not to be an active tab. Okay, from this block, we can uncheck set as active tab here. And for sure, we need to get the translation result at the end. So we need to use get text block here, and it needs element selector. So we will go back again to Google Translate, and we need to know this element. Select Automa extension and click on the element selector here. Click on this and then click the translation result here. copy the selector back again to Automa editor and pass it to the element selector. From the options, we can check wait for selector. Uncheck this and check this for assign it to a variable. We can give it a name like result here. Connect it with the previous blocks. And also, we can close the tab here. And from the active tab, we can running a JavaScript code. Yeah, we will write a simple code here. Like this. Maybe we can write a simple alert here. And we will use the Automa function. Just type Automa ref data, and from the variables we get a result like this. Click on the save button and we can simulate this workflow. From the same text and the same page, we can right click and select run Automa workflow, translate to English. It will automatically open Google Translate and give us an English translation here. Not so hard, right? I will give you a more awesome scenario. We will use WhatsApp Web to send the automatic message with Automa. Let me show you how to do that thing now. Okay, let's create a new workflow again. Give it a name, maybe WhatsApp. Open this workflow, add new tab block here, and we will open https://web.whatsapp.com. Connect it with the trigger block here and click on the save button here. Let's try to execute this workflow. It will open WhatsApp Web and make sure you have already sent in to your WhatsApp Web. What we will do are click on this chat room. Type a message here, maybe hello. And the last thing is, click on the send button here. Okay, let's go back to the first step. We need to click this element, so we need to know what is this element. We can use the element selector from the Automa, and then click on this title. And at this time, I will give you an example that we can use the another attribute name. I will use the title attribute here, so I need to use or copy this value and then back again to the editor, and we can add click element here, and from the CSS selector type square bracket and then the attribute name title equals quote the attribute value, quote, and then close the brackets. From the options, we can check wait for selector here and then connect it with the previous block. Okay, click on the save button, and our expectation is it will open this chat room. Let's try to execute this workflow. Okay, it will open WhatsApp Web, and but it failed to click this element. Okay, we can use the another strategy here. We can use trigger event. From the trigger event, we can select mouse down with a same CSS selector here and same options for wait for selector. So it will simulate the mouse down event in here. We can try to delete this block and connect it with the new tab. Click on the save button here and then try to execute this workflow. Open a WhatsApp Web and then it will open a chat room here. The next step is type a message in this form. Okay? We need to know the element here, so we need to use the element selector too. And then click on this input. We will use the title attribute again. Okay? Copy the value and back again to the editor. and we will add forms block here. And from the element selector, type the square bracket again, type title equals quote the value, and close the bracket. From the options, we can check wait for selector, okay? And we will add the value hello everyone. Okay, we can give it a delay too, like 160 maybe, and connect it with the trigger event. Click on the save button here, and then let's try to execute again. Open a WhatsApp web, click on this, and then type on this input. The last thing is click on this send button. Okay, we need to know again this element, so we can use again element selector here, click on this send button, and at this time we will use the data test ID attribute. Okay, copy the value back again to the editor, select, click element here, connect it with the forms, and then CSS selector, we can use this brackets. And then data dash test ID equals quote send quote close the bracket and select wait for selector. Okay, click on the save button and let's try to execute again. Okay, open the WhatsApp web, type on this, and then click the send button. It's done. I have another idea. What if we create an auto quote from a web page and send it to your WhatsApp using the context menu trigger on Automa? Of course, we need to change this trigger to context menu, give it a name like send to WhatsApp, and it will appear in selection. From the forms block, change the value to double curly brackets, type variables, add $CTX text selection, and close the brackets. Click on the save button here, and from this page, we can select text like this, and then right click, select run Automa workflow, and click on the send to WhatsApp. It will open the WhatsApp web, type this automatically, and then click on the send button. Let's do more complex. We will add a source URL to WhatsApp. Watch me out. First, we need to add active tab block here, and then insert data block. And from the trigger, we need to connect to active tab before, and then connect it with the insert data, and insert data connect to new tab block here. Okay, from the insert data block, we can add a variable with the name maybe URL and the value double curly brackets active tab URL and close the brackets. Now from the forms input, we can add from double curly brackets variables add URL and close the brackets. For the better format, I can use the quote here and triple dots for the CTX text selection. Okay, now let's save this workflow and let's try this in this page. With the same text, we can select and right click run Automa workflow, send it to WhatsApp. Okay, it will type the text selection here, and of course with from the URL. It's done. It's a wrap. If you have any questions, join our Discord server and tell me what you want to know more about Automa by comment below. And thank you for watching.